द्वंद्वात्म नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी creation, was there Advaita or was there Dvaita or something entirely different from Dvaita and Advaita? So was there something in terms of Advaita, non-dual, free from Trikutis, free from these divisions of knower, known and knowing, etc. Again, or was there this Trikuti, Dvaita was there or something entirely different from this? The third possibility, that something different from Dvaita and Advaita is not at all known to anyone in this world, that is totally ruled out. If you say before creation Dvaita was there, you are admitting the creation and you are telling before creation. So we are talking about a state before creation, means creation has not yet started, Dvaita, the Triputis have not yet started. At that time, if you say Dvaita was there, it amounts to say that before creation, creation was there. You are contradicting yourself, and therefore, before Advaita, but before creation, Dvaita is not possible to be there. So therefore, that also is ruled out. Other way, we have seen already, if Dvaita is there, means it is destructible. Destructible means mithya. Mithya means some satya, substratum must be there, the adhishtana must be there, which you have to tell. Otherwise, you will not be able to cognize whatever that is changing without a changeless base. So that also we have seen. So that is ruled out. So what is left out now? Before creation, Advaita alone was there. So this is the Purapakshi object. Right. What you say is correct. But you are establishing the Advaita based on Yukti, the inference. Advaita is not available for experience. You can't experience Advaita. But what you have established is, of course, true, I admit, but based on inference, which is not true. But he is attributing this, that the Advaita has been established by the Vedanti on the basis of inference. To make him understand, a counter question is asked, sir, please let me know, what is that drishtanta, or what is that udharana, or the example based on which I have inferred that Advaita is there, because he is a tarkika. So if inference is there, means anumana is there, means udharana must be there, drishtanta must be there. Just like wherever there is smoke, there is fire. You have to give, like the kitchen. Example you have to give. So like that, without example, inference doesn't work, anumana doesn't work. So therefore, if you say that I have established Advaita based on inference, please let me know, what is that drishtanta that you think that I have got in mind, based on which I have given you, that I have established it, Advaita. You can't say, or you can say, that I have inferred without the basis of drishtanta illustration. Or it can be with drishtanta. Or some third possibility than these two, which is not there, which is ruled out. If you say that I have established, I mean who? You should be careful about when such a discussion is taking place. Who is what? Vedanta. Every time you can't expect me to say, Purapaksha says, and then Vedanti says. So that will not be possible. So even I think I am telling that Purapaksha, etc. At times it is not required, because from the context you can make out, these are the arguments. Okay. So now this, that is what is that drishtanta based on which you claim that I have established the Advaita? If you say no drishtanta, he says you are a very wise person, what a great skillful person, that neither the experience, that you should remember, he is not accepting the experience of Advaita. Neither you are accepting the experience of Advaita, nor have you got any drishtanta to show that I have established Advaita based on the drishtanta inference. So that he says, युक्तिस्तु शोभते सच इन्फरेंस ऑफ यूर्स विच यू आर एट्रीब्यूटिंग टू मी द वेदांते शोभते लुक्स वेरी ब्यूटिफुल मीन द सार्कास्टिक रिमार्क ऑन हिम दैट यू आर टॉकिंग समथिंग नॉनसेंस नाउ द पूर्व पक्ष विल कम नो नो आई विल गिव यू दृष्टांत डोंट वरी आई विल गिव यू दृष्टांत देयरफॉर व्हाट इज दृष्टांत दे ही गिव अद्वैत इज प्रलय स्टेटमेंट व्हाट इज अद्वैत प्रलय मीन्स टोटल एब्सेंस ऑफ द्वैत वाई सो द्वैतानुपलंबेन बिकॉज देर आर नो द्वैतास मीन्स डिविजन्स त्रिपुटीज आर नॉट अवेलेबल अद्वैत इज प्रलय ए डिसोल्यूशन दृष्टांत इफ यू वांट जो पूर्व पक्ष से सुप्ति लाइक द डीप स्लीप आई हैव गिवन यू नो एग्जांपल दिस उदाहरण दृष्टांत आई हैव गिवन यू देयरफॉर आई हैव प्रूव्ड आई मीन्स पूर्व पक्ष से आई हैव प्रूव्ड that you have established Advaita based on Drishtanta. So therefore, it is only purely based on Yukti, the inference, not Anubhava Siddha. You can make a noise, but that Suptivat is questionable. You say that like deep sleep state, which you have given as an illustration, or you are attributing that illustration to me, the Vedanti, please let me know, that deep sleep state you are referring, is it your deep sleep state or someone else's deep sleep state? If you say that illustration of sleep given pertains to your sleep, how come other person is to know? Because illustration when is given should be known to both the parties. The one who is, that means, giving an inference, and other who is trying to understand the thing based on the inference. So if you are giving the experience, you can't say experience because he is not accepting the experience of Advaita means, he is not accepting the experience of even deep sleep state. You can't say my deep sleep state is the illustration because other person will not be able to know your deep sleep state. Therefore, your sleep cannot be the illustration. Therefore, the only option left out for you to say that someone else's sleep like that person's sleep. So that is, the Advaita is pralaya and free from all the Advaita like other person's sleep. He says, you are much more skillful now, much more wise now. Already you are wise, now you are wiser. Why? You are the guy. You don't experience your sleep and you are experiencing someone else's sleep. Look, see, when you are quoting someone else's sleep as illustration, should you know it or not? Should you experience or not? Yes. At the same time, you are claiming that I don't experience my deep sleep state and you are able to experience someone else's sleep.
Yes. Oh, see, Kaushalam Mahat. You are a this is what? You are a great, much more, not ordinarily wise person, but highly wise person. Because you don't know your deep sleep state, and you know someone else's deep sleep state in terms of experience. No, don't accuse me like that. Purapaksha says that. Look, you are just fiddling with the word. What do you mean that? I'm not such a fool as that. When I have given you someone else's deep sleep state as the Drishtanta, I know it, not by experience, I maintain that stand. I mean so, Purapaksha. I do, the Purapaksha says, I do maintain the stand that Advaita's deep sleep state still not available for experience. But I have quoted you the illustration of someone other's sleep based on inference. If you would like to know, I can prove it. How? Come on. Now the Vedanti says, prove that you know someone else's deep sleep state based on inference. Anubhava he can't say. And he gives an inference and there he gets trapped and what? He has to, perforce, he has to accept the experience of his own deep sleep state. And that is the end of it. Because that is what we want to make him understand, not just accept. This is not some fighting in the court, okay? So, look, it is just that, see, that if you dramatize, you can understand better. That's all. Otherwise, don't think Vedanti has got a grudge towards other people, what this cornering, etc. It would have been a simple thing. That is it not a universal experience that everyone knows that the deep sleep state is experienced? But to make understand, here a stand is brought out. A point is brought out. Deep sleep state is not available for experience. And all the possibilities of analyzing are brought and established that deep sleep state is verily experienced. Right? Shruti, Yukti, Anubhuti. Here merely you can't go with the Yukti. Shruti also is there. Anubhava. Shruti is there. Yukti is being given that deep sleep state is the state of Advaya which is experienced. Now the Purapaksha comes out with his so-called inference to prove that other person's sleep is not experienced. It can be inferred. That's what he says. And let us see what he means. Nishteshtatvat parasukto yatha hamiti chetada. उदाहर्तु सुषुप्ते से स्वप्रभत्वं बलाद् भवेत् इन योर बुक देयर इज सुप्तौ इज देयर एनीबडी हु हैज गॉट सुप्तो हां हां दैट श्रृंगेरी देयर सुप्तो यस आई नो जनरली यू विल फाइंड निर्णय सागर एंड अच्युतराय मोडक सुप्तौ. But there is also a reading Sukto. Okay. That is a better reading, we will see. Because Sukta doesn't fit in very well there. Suktaha, that is the one that fits in well. We'll see. First let us take Suktaha, Sukto, and then see the Anvaya. Thereafter we'll see what can be done with the Sukta. Paraha, Suktaha, Nishcheshtatvat. यथा अहम इति के अनुमान एक इंफरेंस परः सुप्तः निश्चेष्टत्वात् यथा अहम इति के तदा उदाहर्तुः ते सुषुप्ते हे स्वप्रभत्वं बलाद् भवेत् तदा उदाहर्तुः ते सुषुप्ते हे स्वप्रभत्वं बलाद् भवेत्. See, first he gives an inference, anumana he gives, that the other person is sleeping and I can know that other person is sleeping from these facts. But anumana, okay, inference. Paraha suptaha, the statement is this. The other person is asleep. How? You have to give first hetu. What is the reason? What is the cause? What is the hetu? The reason because of which you are saying that he is asleep. Nishcheshtatva. He is motionless. One thing you have to add there. He is alive and motionless. Okay. Otherwise he will be motionless. He is dead and motionless. Ramakrishna Tika he adds there. See, pranadimatve sati nishcheshtatva. Pranadipati, prana is there, means you can find out the fellow is breathing, etc. And little heart is beating, you can find out. Otherwise, total emotion is first you have to verify. So, pranadimatve, he is alive, at the same time he is motionless, without any activities, nishchesh tattva. Because I find him lying down, motionless, at the same time he is verily alive. So, therefore what? Nishchesh tattva, therefore he is suptaha. Okay, what is the drishtanta for this inference now? Yatha aham. Like me. Like me means what? Like me, when I sleep, I am nishteshtaha. When I sleep, I am motionless. Have I caught now? I don't know whether you have caught the point. We'll see that. What he says is, because he has to give the illustration. He is asleep. because he is alive at the same time he is motionless. Like what? Drishtanta.
Like me. What does it mean? Yathaham is
just as when I sleep, I am of course alive. That's why I am able to argue with you now. At the same time, I am motionless. Nischeshtaha. Without any activity. What does it mean?
Does he experience sleep or not?
Earlier he was not able to establish his sleep based on the drishtanta or inference. Therefore, he has accepted his anubhava experience of his own sleep. Yatha aham. If you say so, iti che. If you argue like that, my dear sir, tada, in that case, then means in that case, udahartuhu te. In your case, with that udahartuhu, udahartu means one who is giving the illustration. Udahartu te sushupte he of your sleep. Saprabhatvam balad bhave. Balad, per force, you are accepting the saprabhatva means saprakashatva or being self-evident.
How did you know you are sleep?
You have no pramana, that's why you are asking. You have no other means of knowledge to experience. No, to say that you know your sleep because of, oh, I know my sleep because of praksha. I directly perceived my sleep.
Will be seen the next answer. You can
see. Totally ruled out. That is what you are arguing, and you have shown that you can't use the inference. Arthapati, etc., not possible.
No other pramanas are possible.
That is the tada in that case. Udahartuhu. Udahartu means the one who is giving udaharana means the one who is citing the illustration that is you tetava in your face to sute of your sleep. Saprabhatvam means saprakashatvam. Balabhavet. Balad means per force. Means per force you are accepting the saprabhatvam saprakashatvam means experience of your own.
That is what we are telling you from the very beginning. The least is it. Which is totally free from Dvaita, which is Advaita, is experienced. It is not something which is to be known through inference. Therefore, you can't accuse me of Vedanti saying that I have established Advaita based on inference. No, I have told you, Saprabhatve manam anapeksha nasti.
Whatever that is self-evident, saprakasha, self-inner, there is no expectation of mana, pramana, the means of knowledge is not expected. That is what I am telling you from the very beginning, but you are not ready to listen. But now what has happened? Yourself has accepted by force when I ordered it. You are no other guna. You have to say that I do experience.
Okay.
Means, when you, that means you are trying to establish the other person's sleep by inference, you already agreed upon the experience of your sleep. That shows that sleep is something which is sakshi vidya, is known by oneself. It is not something which can be inferred, etc., directly recognized by you. It is self-winner, not sakshi vidya. It is that is saprakasha. Sakshi vidya is something different. Saprakasha. Saksivedya means your thought is Saksivedya. The moment it crops up in your antakarana, what gets illumined by the Sakshaitanya Rupa. It is not that. Saprabhatta means it is self-evident. Self-evident. So, it is self-evident, Saprabhadbhavi. Now, for him to make him understand, what is Saprabhatta is being explained. What do you mean by self-evident? Or that which is evident of its own without the help of any means of knowledge, without the help of any pramana. What do you mean by that? So that is now explained. So what the Siddhanti means by saprabhatva of the sleep of this Purarthi is what is explained in the next one. So that is how that is. Katham balad bhavati
iti ashankya aha.
What is it? That this is, that is, sleep that he has accepted. That by per force, that sleep is something which is experienced. That is not being experienced. Nendriyani na drishtantas tatha pyangi karoshitam.
Nendriyani na drishtantas tatha pyangi karoshitam.
इदमेव स्वप्रभत्वं यद्भानं साधनैर्विना इंद्रियाणि सुप्ति ग्राहकाणि ऐड द रद्याहार न इंद्रियाणि सुप्ति ग्राहकाणि न सन्ति दृष्टांतः न और सुप्ति दृष्टांतः न विल सी दैट इन टेकिंग कमेंटिंग अपॉन दृष्टांतः न तथापि ताम अंगीकरोषि तथापि ताम अंगीकरोषि यद यद साधनैहि विना भानम इदम एव स्वप्रभत्वम् यद साधनैहि विना भानम इदम एव स्वप्रभत्वम् हाउ द स्लीप इज सेल्फ एविडेंट इज नाउ बीइंग एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज मेंट बाय स्वप्रभत्व स्वप्रकाशत्व और स्लीप इज एक्सप्लेन सुप्तिग्राहकाणि इंद्रियाणि न सन्ति आर इज देयर एनी सेंस ऑर्गन बिकॉज ऑफ विच यू आर परसीविंग द स्लीप ही हैड गिवन द एग्जांपल निश्चेष्टत्व लाइक मी लाइंग डाउन मोशनलेस डिड यू सी योरसेल्फ लाइंग डाउन मोशनलेस व्हेन यू आर अस्लीप एनीबॉडी अदर मे सी यू आर लाइंग डाउन मोशनलेस But did you see with your eyes that you are lying down motionless while asleep? Okay, not otherwise. Not lying down. We are not talking of lying down on the bed. You are in deep sleep state. At that time, did your eyes see? I am this word. Sleeping on the bed. Did you see that? No. Therefore, sukti grahakani indriyani. That is, your own senses can't see you sleeping. Seeing Or let us say, snoring. No, I heard myself snoring while I was asleep. You are the person who snores. The fellow will never admit. We have to go move. And in a dormitory, there were so many people there. There was one person with Sapta Swaras, he was snoring. Oh, already cold because of shivering. And we could not get sleep. And Sapta Swaras, different ragas, he was sleeping. And next day, we asked him. He was totally unaware. I didn't snore at all. Like that. Your ears are not available for hearing that you are snoring at that time. See, whenever I conduct camp, I have to find out who snores. While allotting the rooms, because of once Swamiji, for 8 days I had no sleep. The other person in the room snoring. So I thought of putting a question. Do you snore in the application form itself? While enrollment, do you snore or not? Then I thought it's better to get information other way now instead of putting that in the form as well. Anyway, so you can't hear that you're snoring. So at times, some people are going to snore, no, what they wake up. That's fine. But there are others who snore and still they are asleep. Okay. Means enough your senses. Very fact that you are asleep. The indriyas, the senses are what? Resolved in the indriya golak. They are resolved. They are not operating at all. So therefore, perceiving you as a person who is asleep is not possible. That is what is said. Indriyani na. Misupti grahaka indriyani na. Because they are resolved in their respective sense center. For this. Okay. Vishantaha na asti. A drishtant illustration acceptable to both of us. You have given something a drishtanta which is not acceptable, which is wrong. So, a drishtanta which is acceptable to both of us, no, is not there. And yet, what is that now? You are accepting sleep. Tathapi means even means neither your senses are able to perceive your sleep, nor are you able to give a drishtanta illustration to show that sleep is based on, sleep can be proved based on inference, and yet, tathapi, tam suptim, tam pronoun stands for suptim, the sleep, angikaroshi, you accept
Yaha means what? Like means you have accepted the sleep experience of your own.
Sir, this is what is called as saprabhatva or sleep being self-evident. What is that?
Yad adhaihi vina bhanam. Yad bhanam, whatever bhana, bhana yad experience. Knowledge means your experience. Whatever that experience,
what type of experience it is?
Sadhanaihi vina bhanam. That knowledge means that experience without the sadhanas. What sadhanas? Without the jnana sadhana.
Sadhanaihi vina means jnana sadhanam antarena api.
Without any means of knowledge.
Without any means of knowledge, jnana sadhana, sadhanam antarena api,
bhanam, prakashanam means cognition.
Experience there means cognition.
That cognition, without the help of any known means of knowledge,
yad bhanam sadhanai vina, idam eva saprabhatva.
This is verily called as
saprabhatva means a thing being self-luminous, self-evident. Therefore, you have to accept the anubhava of this state, which itself amounts to say that Advaita is available for anubhava. Therefore, I have not proved the Advaita based on inference. It is saprabha. Therefore, it doesn't need any pramana. What can you do now?
Yes, sir.
Accept. Okay.
I accept Advaita as saprabha, based on the illustration of Sukti.
Because he himself has given illustration, but the illustration cannot be inferred, but it is something available in terms of anubhava. So therefore, accept.
Now he asked the question,
how do you say that the deep sleep state is a state of happiness? That is, it is a state wherein whose very nature, sarupa, itself is sukha, ananda.
I hope you remember the context why all this analysis is being carried out. What is it?
To establish Brahmananda.
Brahma, which is Advaita, its swarupa is ananda. Not that Brahma is a locus wherein ananda is placed.
No, it's not that. Like in the basket, the mangoes are kept. In Brahma, what is there? Ananda is kept. No, that is not thing. The Brahma itself is ananda swarupa, sukha swarupa.
So what he has done so far is, based on the analysis of the sukti and yukti, based on the anubhava of sukti, the sweet,
he has established that Brahma is what? Which is anubhava siddha.
Brahma means not Brahma, this Advaita. Advaita, to begin with, Advaita is anubhava.
That what he has accepted.
Now he says that the sukha swarupa vichara, inquiry into the nature of sushupti as the of very nature of ananda,
this inquiry is being conducted from Sattanda 33 to only up to 61. All this. Standard 33 to 61, he is inquiring into the very nature of deep sleep state to point out that deep sleep state is of the nature of ananda. It is ananda swarup. Is it so? You forget the inquiry. What does your experience say? Do you sleep or not? Anybody who doesn't sleep?
And then can't you answer my question?
I am asking, and that also okay. If you were to sleep once in a blue moon, Swamiji, what to do? 15 years back I had slept. I have forgotten what was that experience. And therefore I can't do it. You are, every day you are sleeping, at times in the class also you are sleeping. So how do you say that? You say, please let me know that deep sleep state experience, what is its nature? Ananda or dukkha? Do you know that? यस सर और यस सर यू कांट डिनाई रिसीव इट यू कांट डिनाई द हैप्पीनेस इन द डीप स्टेट अदरवाइज नोबडी विल मेक इट अ पॉइंट टू स्लीप एवरी डे विद ऑल प्रिपरेशन बट वन थिंग इन स्लीप यू आर कमिंग टू द पॉइंट यू आर नॉट एक्सपीरियंसिंग द आनंद ऑफ डीप स्टेट as a present fact of existence. Let us say, I am eating a laddu. I am listening to music. Okay. Here, this Vishyananda, the ananda that is available on account of a particular sense object, I experience this happiness or joy. Like that, I experience this joy of this state is not available. Why not available? But no one can deny that this state is a state of happiness. Not only happiness, it is a state totally free from even the minutest trace of sorrow. Can be happiness, joy is there, but mixed with sorrow. No. Total absence of sorrow and it is happiness. From our experience. But how it is now being established? Okay. This is a state of total ananda without any trace of sorrow. Now be careful. Brahmananda slowly starts. Okay. Now here he was preparing the ground. Now what he is going to do is he is analyzing the deep state. Thereby he is arriving at the Brahmananda. This is what the Brahmananda is. That is not exactly. Alert in terms of means what not exactly. It shows what the Brahmananda is. But to begin with, it is analysis of this. Okay. Now the Pura Paksha says, sir, I do admit. What is that? Advaita is Anubhava. And that is where, how you have proved? With the help of the please let me know how to get to the state of Samadvaitasya Prabhatve Vada Suttau Sukham Katham. Suno Dukham Tadanasi Tataste Shishyate Sukham. Just a minute. The 31st stanza, the Suttau, I didn't tell you. Suttau is for Suttau. Suttau, what is that Suttau? Alternated is. It is not that repeating yourself. So like this can be taken. Parasuttau nishyeshtatvat yatha aham. Not parasu, paraha. Paraha. Suttau nishyeshtatvat yatha aham. Means what you can say is, paraha other person, suptav in the sleep, nishyeshtatva, though alive, he is motionless. Like me, like what? Like whom? Me. Therefore, they have to add that. Therefore, so somebody else's sleep can be given as drishtanta. Not that fine yourself, because you are directly getting the anumana inference here only by taking the suptaha. So anyway, but that reading is available. Which number? Huh? 32 is your acha. So, instead of tathapi is? Acha, then savati is there. Huh? Acha, so tanda is savati and tika is tathapi. Then it's in. Then it's tathapi is correct. Then it's in. So, drishtanta savati. No. Savati doesn't fit in there. Okay. Now he says, look here, means based on the illustration of Mukti means what was termed by him pralaya. Pralaya, dissolution, for which this state was taken into account. So that further on that the Sushupti, which is Advaita, is Saprabha, is now Sukhaprasadhanaya. In that Sushupti, which is Advaita, there is Sukha, means its nature is not there is in that, but its very nature is Ananda Swarupa. To prove that is the Pura Paksha asks a question. Please let me know, how do you say that in this state there is Ananda, or this state is the state of Ananda? How do you say that? It is a question put forth and answer follows. Okay, I am ready for it. Now, Anvayavite. Advaita Svaprabhatve Tam. Stop. Advaita Svaprabhatve Tam. Suktau Sukham Katham Vada. Stop. That is full stop there. Suktau Sukham Katham Vada. Okay, full stop. Then, Shunu, one vakya. Shunu, incident, who is? It's a dialogue now. The dialogue, who tells what you see? You know, one sentence, only because only one word doesn't mean that it is only one. The next sentence is, Tada Dukham Nasti. Further sentence. Tatahati Dukham Shishya. Tatahati Dukham Shishya. First two sentences are by Pura Paksha. First is Advaita Svaprabhatve Stam. Jatam. Stam. Asti. In second conjugation, rarely it is Atmanepada. Asti. Asti. Second conjugation, Atmanepada, rarely it is. So its imperative third person singular is Tam. Let it be so. Or if you take Atmanepada. Rarely Atmanepada. Or not as Atmanepada. So, it is Parasmepada, but rarely it is Atmanepada. In Atmanepada, imperative third person singular is Tam. You can take, if you put the Parasmepada, potential can be Satam. Let it be so. What it means is Satam. So, that's why it is rarely Atmanepada. It is generally not Atmanepada. Rarely Atmanepada. Satam is Atmanepada. Advaita Svaprabhatve Satam. Let these two be. Dual. I mean not singular, it's dual. Okay. Not. Tam is correct. It is dual, not singular. The dual means it is Advaita Svaprabhatve. So, yes, that's correct. That's Tam. Correct. This is the dual. It is Tam is third person dual. What are the Advaita Svaprabhatve? Advaita and nominative dual. It is okay. Advaitatva and Svaprabhatve. That which is Advaita non-dual, at the same time which is self-luminous, self-evident. So, means these two aspects, that is Advaita non-dual and Svaprabhatve, let these two be there. So, dual, okay, not singular. Then you say, Suktau Sukham Katham Vada. That is the case. Please let me know, Suptau, in the deep sea state, Sukham Katham, how there is Ananda, or Guru Paksha may say, in Supti there is Ananda. But Vedanta will say, the Supti itself is Ananda Swarupa. But his question is, in deep sea state, how come there is Ananda? Yujvat, Iti, Vada, please tell me. The Guru Paksha requests the Vedantin, please let me know. That is, I do admit, let it be so that since sleep has got Advaitatva, non-duality, At the same time, Saprabhatva accepted. But please let me know that in sleep, how there is to come Anandam is there. If you were the least, these two sentences are from, are by, made by whom? The Pura Paksha. The Siddhant is saying, to know, if you want to know, please listen. I'm going to elaborate now. Please listen to know. Okay. How the people, if you are asking me the reason why there is Ananda, listen now. This is how it is. It is that as Vidip is said, the state of Ananda. Tada. Tada means tuktau. At the time of this is said, dukkham nasti. There is no sorrow. In the deep state, there is no sorrow. Is it experienced by you or not? There is no sorrow. Tataha, therefore, stay for you in the deep state, sukham shishyate. What remains there is only sukha. Because sorrow and ananda, sukha and dukkha, these are opposed to each other, poles apart. When dukkha is not there, it necessarily means what is there is only. Your experience is that there is no sorrow, therefore what is there in the deep state is dukkha only, ananda. Therefore, the deep state is the state of happiness, the state of ananda. Okay. What Purupakti asked you? He is hammering on Pramana, is it not? Come on, tell me. What is Pramana? Purupakti will ask you, huh? He has not asked, but the Siddhanti presupposes. At times, from the look you can make out. What did you say? Raising the eyebrows means what? Earlier he has explicitly asked the Pramanas. Now from his face, the Siddhanti must have understood this, why he is asking. What is the means of knowledge that it is so? Therefore, before he could ask, he says, yes, Pramana is there. Two Pramana. One is universal experience. Other thing is Suti. Vedas also declare to this effect that the state of, the deep state is the state of Ananda. To the total exclusion of sorrow. And it is so universally experienced by one and all. Therefore, it is the answer stated in Pratipadita. Suktau dukkha bhavi kimmanam iti akanshayam shrutyanubhavau ityah. So, suktau in the discourse. There is no sorrow in the deep state. What is the pramana? What is the means of knowledge? Iti akankaya. If certain expectation is there, if you ask me like that, these are the two. What are those? Suti and anubhava. Suti and anubhava. Suti and anubhava. Universal experience. These two pramanas can be cited.
Andhastannapyanandhasyad viddho viddho tarogyapi. Arogiti shruti praha tachya sarve jana viduhu. Andhaha san
api
anandhaha sya
san vat api vat anandhaha san apyanandhaha.
Andhaha san
api
anandhaha Vidhaha, avidhaha.
There is avagraha there, okay? Vidho, vidho, vaivese. But vidhaha, avidhaha.
Vidhaha, avidhaha.
Again, vidhaha, avidhaha.
Atha, rogi,
api,
rogyapi.
Rogi,
api,
arogi,
iti,
utihi, praha. Tatya. Sarve janaha vidu. I think better we take the Suti first. It's based on Chandogya Suti. ज्ञाद्वा एतम सेतुम सीत्वा अंधः सन् अनंधः भवति विद्धः सन् अविद्धः भवति उपतापि सन् अनुपतापि भवति तद् यद्यद् अपि इदं भगवः शरीरं अंधं भवति अनंधः स भवति
sorrows of the blindness.
Not that he gets vision. In sleep, what happens is, a person who was blind, when he sleeps, what happens? The Atmanam Prapti, again, one is one with Atman. That's how we can put it. Oneself is one, the individual is one with Atman. Means there is no difference. That's why Prapiti means when you gain oneself, that is called swapiti. It is sandogya, that derivation is sandogya, it is itself. Because swapiti means sleep with it. You know what is sleep mean? Even that verb sleep itself is what? Swapiti is swapiti. One gains oneself. It is sleep. Think of it. In sleep, where are you? How far is Atma from you? In sleep, Atma is near. In waking and dream, where Atma is far. So, that is,
Andha san anandha bhavati.
Hitherto, who was a blind in his sleep? Does he know that he is blind? Or afflictions arising out of blindness, are they there? No. His anandha means he is free from the sukha defect of blindness. Why? Whom does the blindness belong? To the upadhi, the eyes. He is free from upadhi at that time. Again he says, other thing. Viddha san avidha bhavat. Viddha. He was wounded by weapons. He had gone to war, a soldier later. And there was yuddhe shastrahataha. He was wounded by weapons in the war. Susupta, what happened? Avidha. Avidha means shastrahati badha nanubhavat. He doesn't experience the pain on account of wounds caused by the weapon. After waking up, yes. When you see, that's why, suppose, the fellow is operated. Morphine injection is given. What for? So there is not pain, there is not experience. But suppose, you can't go on giving morphine. After that, it's meditative only. Because he is made to sleep. Then, hours, that is, severe the pain may be, it is not experienced by the individual. It is what is said, avidha bhavati. Upatapi san anupatapi bhavati. Upatapi means afflicted by disease. A cancer patient. But he is asleep. Will there be the pain of cancer? He may not get sick and different. Because he is asleep, by any means, let us say he is asleep, there is no pain at all. So, upatapi san, though being afflicted in the waking, he is no more experiencing the pain of that particular roga disease. Sukhbed Raja, tat yadyadapi idam bhagavaha shariram andham bhavati anandaha sabataha bhavati. It is not entire quotation from Sanghoji. One portion is from Sanghoji. Because repetition is there. This is what is meant there. Now let us see the Tanja. Andaha san api anandaha. Andaha san. There you have to add. Jagradavastayam andaha san. Being himself blind. When? In the waking state. If the person is blind. In the waking state, he was blind. Jagradavastayam andhasan, being blind, api, even then, anandhasyat, where suttau, in the deep state, he becomes anandhani, he is no more blind, means he doesn't experience the pain or whatever the drawback of being blind. That's true. I am a blind person. All the time in the waking, he is not that remote. That is not there in the wounded by the weapons in the waking state, during the deep state, he has no more pain of that. Atha swalti rogi api, even though a patient, even though suffering from some illness, even though he is sick in the waking state, arogi, in the deep state, he is free from that disease. Iti. So, Shruti hi praha. So the Shruti, Chandogya Shruti has declared, it shows that in the deep state, there is no sorrow at all. Now, not only Shruti has said, it shows the universal experience. Tachya. Tachya means that fact that in the deep state, there is no sorrow. Sarve janaha viduhu. All people may universally experience that in the deep state there is no sorrow at all. So that is, this is the pramana for you to know that in the deep state there is no sorrow. The Purva Kshatri says, sir, you have told this. What did you say? How did you establish the Sukha Ananda in the deep state? By pointing out. There is no sorrow. But only because there is no sorrow, there is ananda, there is a vabhichara. Cannot improve. You cannot accept. You can't make a gap. Not in it. A rule. A sahacharaniyam. Wherever there is absence of sorrow, there is happiness, you can't make it improve. Why? I can point you out the exception where your rule fails. That's what the Purva Kshatri says. It is not correct. It is wrong. He is giving a wrong illustration. It is answered. He says, here is a store. Sutta. See, you should give credit to this Purva Kshatri. Modern person poses as rational, never think. At least these people are thinking. And at times they were thinking in a different manner. It's not ordinary joke. They were thinking persons. He has thought over that. See, here is a stone. Is there sorrow in that? No sorrow. Therefore, what should we say? Happiness must be there. Do you find any happiness? Therefore, there is no happiness. Therefore, your statement is all the time this Vedanta wriggles out, now he can't escape. Earlier what he has said, yatra dukkha bhavaha tatra sukham. Sahacharya Niyamaha. Invariable concomitant. मुखा भावः वरवर दरीद अब्जन्त आक्षारु तत्र सुखम दरीद आनंद सुख दिस व्याप्ति ऑफ युवर इज डिफेक्ट आई कैन पॉइंट आउट व्यभिचार मीन वेर इट इज वायलेट वेर लोष्टाद इन अ क्लाउड ऑफ अर्थ इन अ स्टोन एटसेट्रा आई कैन पॉइंट आउट दैट युअर रूल डजंट अप्लाई That is what he says in answering him. But the Pura Patra, then Vishamam Vachaha, that is the answer, which is elaborated after. Madukha Bhava Matrena Sukham Loshta Siladishu. Vaya Bhavasya Drishtatva Diti Ched Vishamam Vachaha. लोष्टशिलादिषु द्वयाभावस्य दृष्टत्वात् एट् दैट् तत्र दुःखाभावमात्रेण न सुखम् इति चेत् अप् टु हियर् पूर्वपक्ष तत्र तु एडेड् दुःखाभावमात्रेण न सुखम् इति चेत् तद् आन्सर् फालोस् विषमं वचः स्टेट्मेंट इज एन इंप्रॉपर स्टेटमेंट इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद व्हाट आई हैव इफ यू कैन अप्लाई इट इन इन दैट लोकेशन ऑफ टू एटसेट्रा या व्हाट इज दिस इज लोष्ट शिलादिषु लोष्ट एक्लॉड अ लंप ऑफ Siladishu, in the stone, or a rock, etc. In that inert thing. What it means is inert thing to be, dead thing, inert. In this inert thing like this, what we find is, Vayabhavasya Drishtatva. We neither find sukha nor any there, neither sorrow is there, nor the joy is there. Means, What we want to take now is there is no sorrow. But according to you, there must be sukha ananda. But we don't find any ananda at all there. Vaya bhavasya. Vaya here is sukha dukha. Because of absence of sukha and dukha, krishtatvat, because these two are the absence of these two, it seems that Therefore, tatra, there in the stone, loshta shiladishu, in the stone, etc. Dukkha bhava matrena sukham na sukham bhavati. Only because there is absence of sorrow, there is sukha ananda. This statement of yours doesn't hold good. It is said, if you argue so, it is said, vishamam vachaha. Answer is your vacha, this argument or this statement is improper out of context. Why out of context? This lesson, what are the means at your disposal to verify that in the stone etc. there is neither sukha nor dukha. I am talking about the person where the sorrow is not there, which can be very easily cognized. Not by experience. That fellow has sorrow, I can't. Can you experience? You have to find out other methods. That will be. But in your case, it is wrong because you can't verify. How you can't verify?